Hi, my name's Mariah Christensen. I work for Harmon's Grocery. I'm an ACS certified cheese professional, and we're gonna be making cheese today. There are 8 basic steps of cheese making. The first step is setting the milk. Then your next step of cheese making is to cut the curds. Step number 3 is cooking and holding. Step number 4 is to drain the whey. Step number 5 is to knit the curd. Step number 6 is pressing the curd. Then you add the salt. This is to help preserve your cheese and add flavor. The last step, number 8 of cheese making, is special applications, which means anything different that you do along the way. You might do something different with flavors, or you might add some other yeast or bacteria to help change the flavor of your cheese. The things from your kitchen you'll need to make cheese today are 2 mixing bowls, 2 stock pots, a strainer, measuring cups, measuring spoons, a slotted spoon, a chef's knife, cheesecloth, gloves, and a thermometer. The ingredients for cheese making are milk, citric acid or lactic acid bacteria, rennet, and salt. Now let's make cheese. Step 1 is setting the milk. We're going to be measuring our first 2 ingredients. The first one is liquid rennet. We will be mixing 1/4 teaspoon of the liquid rennet with 1/4 cup of cool water. The other ingredient that will help us set the milk is citric acid. We will use 1.5 teaspoons of citric acid with 1/2 cup of cool water. Okay, so the reason we want to add the citric acid is to start acidifying the milk. This helps the proteins to break down so that they aren't stuck in the middle of the water. You want to separate the proteins from the water. When you have your milk, the proteins are hydrophilic, so they love the water and stick to the water. When the proteins collide, they don't stick to each other, so you need to break them down so that they'll stick together to make your cheese. The liquid rennet and the citric acid are going to do that for us and set the milk into a curd. The citric acid is all dissolved, so we're going to move on to the next part of our recipe and finish setting the milk now that we have our ingredients ready. So we're going to put our citric acid with the water into our pot, and then 1 gallon of milk. This is the part to start the milk acidifying. You want to make sure that you're using really high quality milk from a reputable source. And since this is a fresh cheese, you want to make sure it's pasteurized milk. Make sure you have very low somatic cell count, which is bacteria that comes from the animal, very low bacterial count, which comes from the environment, like the milking parlor being dirty, and you want to make sure there are no antibiotics in the milk. That will all mess up your cheese making process. So now we have our milk in here, we're going to start heating the milk up. We're using a water bath today for the cheese making because it's easier to control how quickly your milk heats up so it doesn't get too hot. Today we're going to take the milk to 95 degrees. Now we've reached 95 degrees for our milk, so we're going to add our second ingredient that will help with setting the milk. And that's the rennet that we dissolved in the 1/4 cup of cool water. So I'm gonna add all that now. Rennet is an enzyme, so that's gonna help you break down your protein. We're gonna stir that for 30 seconds. The enzyme clips off the outside of the protein, making the proteins able to stick together instead of being just stuck in the water and loving the water. Now when the proteins start bumping into each other, they'll start sticking together to make our curd. Once we have stirred this for 30 seconds, we're gonna let it sit for 5 to 10 minutes, and you can tell that your curd is ready when it looks like a custard and the sides of the pot have clear liquid. Okay, we'll let that set for 10 minutes and keep it around 95 to 100 degrees. We've been waiting 10 minutes for our curd to set up. Now we're gonna check that to see if it is ready to go to the next step. So we're gonna check that by putting the spatula in by the edge of the pot and pulling it away a little bit. You get to see the clear whey there, and it's set up like a loose custard. So kind of putting texture on the curd. So we're ready to go on to step 2 of cheese making, which is cutting the curd. Just Just using a chef's knife, and we're gonna cut that into about 1-inch squares. You wanna be gentle with it as you cut it so you don't break it up too much. It's gonna start shifting on you a little bit. Cutting the curd allows the whey to get out of the curd. The curds are floating on the top of the whey. The whey is mostly water and has whey protein in it. That's why it's called whey. And the curds have most of the casein protein in it and all the fat from the milk. We're going to drain the water and put new hot water in. This is for our third step of cheese making, the cooking and holding. So we're going to bring this back up to 95 to 100 degrees Fahrenheit and let it sit for about 3 minutes. Now we're going to move on to step 4, which is draining the whey. We'll be using a strainer lined with cheesecloth and a slotted spoon to move our curds into the strainer. So I'll put the strainer, cheesecloth, and the slotted spoon. Gently scoop your curds out of the whey into the strainer. And let all the whey drain. This is also going to start step 5 of our cheese making because the curds will start knitting together and fusing back into one big mass of cheese. We'll let that drain and knit together for a few minutes. For mozzarella, it's just pressed by the weight of the cheese. We don't add any extra pressure to that because we want to keep some water in our mozzarella so it's nice and soft. We're now going to salt the curd, which is step 7. We're just using a half teaspoon of sea salt and putting that right on the curd. This will get mixed into the curd in our next step. Our last step for mozzarella is going to be the special application, step 8. And for mozzarella, it's a pasta filata style cheese. That means stretched curd. So you reheat all the curds and stretch them kind of like taffy to get the proteins to realign so that you get the meltable pizza cheese that we all love. We've been heating water and we're getting it to 175 degrees. If your water's too hot for the mozzarella, you're going to lose more of your fat and protein in the water and you won't end up with the same soft cheese. I'm going to put on a pair of gloves so that I can put my hands in this hot water. Lift your curd out of the strainer and break it into about 1-inch pieces. This helps to distribute the heat evenly through your mozzarella curd. I'm letting the mozzarella curd heat up so that it will melt. Just push it against the edge of the bowl here to help it stick together. Once it's heating up, you can push all of those curds back together and start to pull it, folding it over on itself. If it's ripping, it's not quite hot enough, so you put it back in your hot water for a minute. Once all of your curds are melted, it's gonna be glossy on the outside, shiny, and it won't rip anymore as you start to pull it like taffy. And then fold it back together. Gotta need a little more heat on that. And I'm tucking all the ends underneath. It's kind of like working with bread dough. I'm gonna rip off the extra, and there is our mozzarella ball, all ready to go into a cold water bath to cool off. Here's our finished fresh mozzarella cheese. Thank you for joining us today for the 8 steps of cheese making.